Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build my ultra-compact 14x14 double wall door, which you can see here right in front of you. It's been lying in my testing world for quite some time, but I finally found the time to actually make the tutorial for this. Anyway, what is this about? Well, as you can see at the moment, we have this 14x14 tunnel with some buttons on each end, and if you press any of those, you will see that shortly after that, the door will start to close. Pretty fast actually, and soon we have this very nicely looking vault door design here, which is replicated at the back, so this is a double-sided vault door of a 14x14 size. Obviously you can open it up from each side by simply pressing the buttons again, which by the way are completely spam-proofed, so there is no chance of accidentally destroying your door by pressing the buttons too soon. And as you can see, very quickly, the door is flattened out again, and we are back to our tunnel. So that's basically what this thing is about. Now the size of this whole thing is 34 blocks in width, then it's 32 blocks high, this opening is in the dead center of this thing here, and it's a total of 15 blocks long. This already includes the front and the back wall, since there is some circuitry below the floor at the same layer. So that's the overall sizes. This is a ultra compact design, and there are not that many ways to make this even just a tiny bit smaller. So this is already very, very compact for a door of that size opening. And with that, let's talk about the required resources. So obviously you're gonna need building blocks. So pretty much any full and movable block will do, but you will need a lot of them. There are a couple thousand blocks right in there, so a lot of them. Then you're gonna need a total of 333 obsidian blocks and 77 steps. Quite nice numbers right there. Anyway, furthermore, you're gonna need 4 sand blocks, then exactly 100 honey blocks, and 426 slime blocks. The glowstone blocks you can see here are just there to light up the space. They are not required for this thing here to work and subsequently not mentioned in the required resources. For redstone components, you're gonna need about 688 redstone wire or redstone dust, then a total of 88 redstone torches, then 143 redstone repeaters, 84 redstone comparators, 178 observers, 4 droppers, 42 hoppers, 46 node blocks, then 170 null pistons and 366 sticky pistons, so almost 5 stacks, 6 levers, at least 2 buttons, although you can add a few more. For this example here I've used 4, and 3 chests, plus a few additional items to place in this chest, but I will mention what you need to put in them later on during the tutorial. And furthermore, you're gonna need a lot of items that have a stack size of 16. For this tutorial I'm gonna use X, but any item with a stack size of 16 will do. So you could, for example, also use things like snowboards, which may be even easier to get in the required amounts. How many do you need? 23 stacks and 12, or as a number, 380, so quite a lot. And those are the required resources. So let's finally show you how to build this door here. Okay, so the first step is marking the middle of the floor of the door with 2 immovable blocks. So these 2 blocks here are at the center of our future door, or right below the center to be more precise. Then from the right one of those 2 blocks, go down 8 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then remove the 7 in the middle again. And that's where we want to start with our circuitry. Now for the next few parts, the entire thing is symmetrical, so I'll show you how to build the front half, and then you will simply mirror this towards the back, along this center plane. Obviously, if I'm building something in the center, it will be mirrored onto itself. So let's continue on. So we have our block down here. Now we place a block towards the front, or when you mirror it towards the back. Then we put redstone dust on top of those two blocks. Next, we need a node block next to the block at the front, and an observer on top of that. Then towards the right, add four sticky pistons facing upwards, and then below the fourth one, we need another sticky piston facing upwards. Then top everything with five slime blocks, and then a sticky piston here. Another sticky piston diagonal to the first sticky piston down there, and an observer running directly into it, like so. Then in the middle of our build, we start with stairs of four obsidian blocks going up, like so. Then, continuing downwards, we have an observer running into the space below this obsidian block there. And another observer running downwards, like so, right in front of this observer. Put redstone dust on top of all these blocks, with the exception of the last one. Then we need a block here with a repeater in this direction. And for some reason, I will place the mirrored one already there. And now we can place a full block here. I placed the mirrored block already there since this would trigger the observer and you would have potentially to replace parts. So anyway, let's continue on. Now we need a raised block here and then two lowered blocks put down to redstone wire. So now this block here next to the bottom piston is also powered. After mirroring, grab a torch and place it next to this middle block or on the side of this one. Then block diagonally and take an output from the torch with a repeater on 3 ticks. Run this into a full block with block to the side, diagonally down, and then we go twice up diagonally. Put down 2 redstone wire here. Then we need a sticky piston next to this block with an observer on top. On top of that extended observer, we need a obsidian block with a redstone cross on top. Then we go back to this corner here. And first place a block to the front in this case, then diagonally inwards up. Then we continue with 2 more obsidian blocks. Then in the opposite direction, place a block at the same height. Then a node block around the corner. And then we go diagonally down, like so. Put redstone wire on top of the blocks you placed just now, with the exception of the top obsidian block there. Go back to this corner. And place a sticky piston below the node block and next to this block down there. Then we need observers in those positions here. Then full blocks with a 1 wide gap to those observers. Place another block here, put some redstone dust on top, and run this directly into a node block. Come on. Like so. Then place basically the same configuration as you have placed at the back there, so first one down and then twice up with 2 redstone wire in the middle there. This time the normal piston is on top of the block. Then place an observer on top of this node block here, followed by 3 sticky pistons towards the side, which should end up next to this normal block. Put four slime blocks on top, and then sticky pistons to the front, back, and to the left side of this configuration right there. So the next part is not entirely symmetrical, so I will show you the whole thing without mirroring during a cut. So we go back to the center line here and start with a raised block right there. Then towards the back, and only towards the back, we need a lowered block here with a comparator running into the block we just placed. Then a block behind that, and on top of the comparator, and 1 more raised, and then 2 lowered blocks here with a torch on this last block there. Put redstone dust on the blocks all the way over there, with the exception of the top raised block here. Then place a block right diagonally to this block there. Comparator here. Then add another block of a comparator behind that. Then a raised block and 2 blocks lowered to the side here. Put this one comparator in a subtract mode and then place 2 more like so. Behind them, we need 2 hoppers facing each other. Then, diagonally to the torch, we need a lowered block here and then a raised block there. Put some redstone dust there, which should power the block right below this hopper right there. Then, place a block here the torch on the side of it, like so. And now it's time to fill those hoppers here. First, to the left hopper, you add 12 eggs. And then to the right hopper, you add first 4 and then another 15. So 19 in total. And that's this more or less finished. Now let's continue on with a sticky piston on top of this torch right there. Observer facing towards the, or powering towards the left. Then we need a upside down slab like this here. On top of the slab, we need a repeater on one tick running into a full block. Add another block to the front. Then two obsidian blocks like so. Put some redstone dust on top. A repeater on 4 ticks in this direction. And then we have essentially the same thing at the back here. So the repeater on 4 ticks, our two obsidian blocks, and then our line of blocks until we connect with over here. And once more, some redstone wire on top. Like this here. Then go back to this block right there. On the right of that, we need a lowered block with a redstone cross on top. Then towards the front, place a block with a sticky piston on top, facing downwards this time. Then a lowered block right there with a repeat on vortex running into the block right below the sticky piston. Then a raised block, and then around the corner, we need a couple more lowered blocks like so, 5 in total. First add, sorry, 6 in total. First add 3 repeaters on 4 ticks each, then a repeater on 2 ticks, and then a repeater on 3 ticks, then some redstone wire. Put an observer looking at this first repeater on top of it, then block on top of the observer, block next to that redstone cross on top, raised block, lowered block with a repeater on 3 ticks, running into the raised block, then 2 lowered blocks here, and some redstone dust on top of those 2 lowered blocks. Then, towards the front of our build, we go diagonally to the line of blocks here, and first towards the right until we are one further than this row of blocks there, and then we go up twice diagonally. Put some redstone dust on top of those blocks, and a torch on the back of this block here. This will be the connection or power line to the right side. And then we go towards the left with this line of blocks until we are in line with the very first blocks we placed down here. Again, redstone dust on top. Then we have another 2 blocks lowered towards the back here, redstone dust on top. And then another 3 blocks down here. And now technically you could place redstone dust on top of those, but if you want to have the first extension of the bottom and the top part being synced properly, you will need a 10 tick delay, so 2 repeaters on 4 ticks and 1 on 2 ticks. And that's this part done. Now we could theoretically test everything out, so let's put a lever here and turn it on. And you should see now all of those here extending. And if we depower this lever here, you should see the proper sequence going in reverse. So that's basically what we want to see, and this is looking good so far. Now it's time to go towards the left a bit more. First we have a raised block next to this redstone wire, then a lowered block, then another raised block, and then 4 lowered blocks, put a repeat on one tick in this gap here, then 4 redstone wire on top of those blocks. Then towards the back we need a row of 6 blocks going left as you can see here. Put some redstone wire here, then a repeater on 4 ticks, 2 ticks, 4 ticks, 4 ticks, and 4 ticks. Then a raised block, then around the corner towards the back another lowered block with a repeater on 4 ticks running into a full block with and lowered block to the back with some redstone dust in a cross shape behind it. Then a sticky piston on top of this one here, facing downwards. Raised block next to the redstone cross towards the right in this time, with a torch right there. Then an observer looking at this first repeater here. On top of that, a block, lower block, raised block, then a lower block, raised block, and then two lower blocks in the direction of the sticky piston. Redstone cross here, repeater on three ticks there, and then two redstone wire there. Now grab two hoppers and place them facing each other, next to the torch and the block like this here. So essentially building a same construction like this here, just one block lower. Then towards the back, we need lowered blocks with comparators taking an output from the hoppers. This back one runs into this left one runs into a full block. Then we need two lowered blocks here with comparators on top. This one here must be in the subtract mode and runs into a full block with some redstone dust on top. Following that, let's go back to this middle block there. First, place two blocks towards the front and the back. Put redstone dust on top. Then at the front one here, place a torch on the side of this block with a block diagonally and then a block diagonally up there. Put some redstone dust here, which should now power via the torch and the block here, this hopper. Now it's time to place first 12 eggs into the right hopper here, and then place 19 eggs, so 4 plus 15 eggs into this left hopper here. Then let's go back to the front here. First, place a row of blocks parallel to the block with the repeaters. Put redstone dust on top. Then we need a lowered L shape of three blocks here going backwards. Put redstone dust on top of this. A raised block here and an upside down snap there. Put some redstone dust here, cut off that wire with a full block there, and then a repeater on one tick there, running into a full block with a torch to the side of it like so. This is similar to this torch over there, the connection to, in this case, the left side. Then go back to this wire down here, place a block in front of it. Then we need a lowered block, raised block, lowered block, redstone dust here, and a repeater on one tick running to this block there. Then place a sticky piston next to this block there. Block below it with a torch right there. Then with a two-wide gap essentially, we need another block here with a torch, so we now have two torches facing each other. Another sticky piston up there. Then block here, then there, and a raised block in those corners. Put some redstone dust here and here. Now it's time to grab two comparators. Place them facing like so. Then in between two hoppers facing each other, like this. And now place first two blocks up here with redstone dust on top. Then a torch on the front one, so this sticky piston here extends. Then place a block in here. This is important that you do it in this order. And then place another torch on top of this sticky piston here. And now finally, let's place 24 items of any kind into this back hopper here. And now we can go to the front here and actually remove this lever here. Because now our input is actually this redstone wire here. So let's see if everything works out. So let's grab a button and let's press that button here. And you should see, now obviously this hopper clock here has changed its state, or this spam proofing has changed its state, and you can see the part over there is reacting, and once we have the circuitry finished down here, we should also see this half here working. So now this thing here is spam-proofed and there is no real danger of accidentally destroying our build. Now lastly, before we start with the actual mechanics in the middle, let's first remove this one here and then let's place a block first on top of this comparator there, then next to that an upside down slab Then we go up twice diagonally towards the front and add another three blocks towards the front. Put Ritzendust on top of those blocks here. And the torch, sorry, first another block here with Ritzendust on top and then a torch here, which should connect to this layer there. And this is our new input on the front. So let's place our button for now here. We will later on place it in a bit more easier to reach area. Then add another three blocks here. Then we go up twice diagonally and add another three blocks next. So this should be symmetrical along this line here. Yep. And once more, redstone dust on top. And another button on this end here. And now we get finally to this part here. This part once more is symmetrical, so I will show you again. Oh, wait, before we get to this part, actually place a sticky piston on top of our torch down there, observer on top of that one, facing towards or powering towards the red. Upside down step here, then a repeater on one tick taking an output, running into a block like this here, and then we have four raised blocks towards the back with some redstone dust on top. And now the rest is pretty much symmetrical, so once more, mirror along this plane here. Now for the front half, first go to this block down in the middle there. And here we need a lowered block diagonally with a comparator running into this direction. This runs directly into a raised full block with a lowered full block towards the back. Then we have towards the right first a lowered block, then a raised block, and then we go diagonally with another three obsidian blocks. Put Ritzen dust on top of those blocks, with the exception of this one and the last obsidian block. Then in the middle of our build, so middle line, we need a sticky piston here with an observer to the face. Then diagonally with a one wide gap, we need a lowered block here with another one to this side. Put down two repeaters on one tick each, run them into a full block with some redstone dust on top. Then, next to the redstone dust, we need a hopper with some redstone dust on top of it, right in this gap there. Then let's go and add a row of four sticky pistons beginning next to this normal block with four slime blocks on top. And then another slime block here and another slime block raised there. Put a sticky piston here and here. And an observer running into this top slime block here from the front in this case. Then let's go back to this block here. First we need another block next to that. And now we are essentially somewhat coping for the most part this whole system over there. So first we need a node block here, then a lowered block next to that, put redstone dust on top, then a sticky piston down here with an observer, then we have a one wide gap with in this time three blocks, redstone dust on top of those. So instead of the node block over there, we need just some redstone dust, put an observer on top. Then another three sticky pistons like so. Slime blocks on top, sticky pistons on the right end from the back, like so. Then on the inside here, we need essentially first a normal block there, put another normal block down there, and then two more obsidian blocks going up diagonally. Put redstone dust on top of those three blocks here, with the exception of this one over there. So after mirroring, let's quickly go back to this gap here, and first go one block down and one block up from this block with the single redstone dust on top. Then we go once more one block down, one block up, and then we go once more one block down, one block in the same direction, so not up, and then we go up. Some redstone dust in this gap, then a repeat on one tick in this gap, then three redstone wire here, and then cut off the wire here with a full block. Then run this wire directly into a sticky piston with two slime blocks on top, then a observer running into the top slime block, and on top of that a sticky piston. Then let's go and first add a repeater on vortex on top of this obsidian block here. So we are building something similar to this over there. So again, two slime blocks behind that and a raised normal block there, or normal block at the same height here, and then just some redstone wire to connect this. And now let me quickly mirror this again. Next, place first a block following this line of blocks here, and then a raised block. Put a repeater on two ticks running into this block, then we need a lower block to the side with some redstone dust on top. Then go to the center and first place a block on top of this last comparator there. Then we go up twice diagonally and add another two blocks here and then a raised block there next to the redstone cross. Put redstone dust all the way down here. Then place a torch on the side of this block. Next, diagonally towards the front of that, we need a block followed by three blocks towards the right. Then we have three lowered blocks, two raised blocks, then two lowered blocks, two raised blocks, then another three lowered blocks, and finally one raised block. Then, with the exception of the last block, place redstone dust on top of those blocks here. Then two redstone wire here, and on the third of those blocks in the row, place just a one tick repeater. Then, starting with the block with the wire following the repeater, place torches on the raised blocks and on the center lowered blocks on those three block segments. Then let's place normal pistons next to the lowered redstone wire. And sticky pistons on top of those torches. Just like this here. Now before we continue, one quick correction. This two-tick repeater here needs to be placed on top of an immovable block like obsidian. I corrected this at the back already. Or otherwise, once those blocks here start moving, they will get stuck to the ceiling here and it will self-destruct. Anyway, let's now add a few more blocks. Once more, it's symmetrical, so I'll show the front half and then mirror it during the cuts towards the back. So first of all, let's start with obsidian blocks next to those middle normal pistons, then one behind this single sticky piston in the middle there. Then on the right side, we need two obsidian blocks above the corners between those three sticky pistons there. And on the left side, we only need it at the front corner here, or the outside corner. Next, let's add a few more slime blocks, or let's actually see if everything works until up to this point. So press the button and you should see this one here being activated, then the next segments and the next segments and so on. So you essentially have the movement starting in the middle and then pretty much every step another module here starts moving with this entire setup. And if we press the buttons again, you get this double action going on, and then the whole thing goes in reverse, so the last parts that stop are in the middle. So that's what we want to see. Now, once we have ensured that this is at least somewhat working, let's add our slime constructs. And for that we start right on top of this sticky piston in the middle, with a column of slime blocks until we are just below the floor, where we continue with an L shape to the side, in this case the left. Then this block here, or the sticky piston, is connected to the same construct, so we start with a one high gap above it. Again, until we are right below the floor, and then one to the left. Here, this is the first sticky piston when we count from the inside, so we go directly on top of it, L shape to the left. This one here is connected to this one here, so one high gap, L shape to the right this case. This one here is the first, so just 3 blocks straight up, no L shape in this case. Then one high gap, L shape to the right. Two high gaps, so in this case we just have, three wide column or row of blocks. And then in the middle here, this gets our three blocks in an L shape there. And here we more or less mirror, so three high column, then one high gap, and L shape towards the left. And here we just have our two high gap and the three blocks there. So that's the slime constructs. Now let's add the normal pistons. So essentially everywhere where you have right below the floor a slime block, you need in front of that a level down a normal piston. So a pretty straightforward pattern actually, and not that difficult to figure out. And those are the last ones. And at this point we might give it a test run. So press the button, and you should see that you essentially start building up a kind of pyramid-like pattern. Like this here, which should flatten out once the entire thing has retracted again. And as you can see, if everything works properly, you have your flat area again. Now, last part is actually filling in a couple blocks. Let's start with the immovable blocks in the floor, wherever slime blocks will get in touch with. Those are the positions here and on this side here. So that's the outer edge of the slime constructions, and let's start filling in this with normal blocks. And before we start mirroring, there is one more step we should consider, and that is making sure that we have every place where slime blocks get in contact with the floor actually mapped out. So just press the button again, let the entire thing close up, and now we can see, okay, we have one area here where we have to be careful, and a bit more of an area here and here. And once we have mapped that out, I can start filling in the rest here with blocks and have the entire thing retract again. And we should now be able to see if we have missed a part. And as you can see, this half is completely finished. So all that's left is pretty much just mirroring it and maybe filling in a bit more of the floor. And voila, so as you can see, now I have finished this up. And now you could give it a final test run to see if everything works properly. While doing this last step, I actually noticed that I missed two parts in the entire thing. So you may have noticed earlier that I actually missed down here adding the hopper and at the back adding a bit of redstone wire here. So two of the segments weren't properly triggered and would not extend. So this is one thing I had to correct in the intermediate. But if you're properly mirrored, you should not have that issue. Anyway, as you can see, now we have those two bottom segments or bottom parts completely extending, which is good, and they should also properly and completely flatten out. So, as you can see, everything works now properly, which means now it's time to build the two sides. Okay, so the two sides are built exactly the same, just mirrored. So for this tutorial here, I will show you how to build the right side and then mirror it during the cuts towards the left side. There are also quite a few parts where there is a front-to-back symmetry, and in those cases I will show you just how to build one quarter of the door and then mirror this twice during the cut. So first for one side and then to the other side. Just as a little heads up. Now, one thing I want to mention here is, while building this, there is a good chance that items will fall into those hoppers here and will most likely end up into this hopper here and maybe even in this hopper. If that happens, just take them out after you are done. Just make sure that at the end you have your 31x in total in here. This is the only thing you should be aware of, or otherwise the timings between the two sides may no longer be correct and this whole thing here will break if you try it out. Just before you test everything, always make sure that you have the correct number of items inside of those hoppers. Anyway, the starting point for the right side is right on top of this torch in the corner here. On the left side, it's the torch in this corner. Now, let's start with a block on top of the torch. Torch on top, block on top, torch on top. Then add another three blocks to the back of this block here. Put down two redstone wire and a repeater on four ticks. Run this into a full block. Then we have a lowered L shape towards the right with three redstone wire. Now our second symmetry starts, so I will show you just this quarter here and then mirror that twice. We start with a block next to this block of the redstone wire. Put a repeater on four ticks, going in this case towards the front, and run this into a full block. Then we need a lowered block towards the right and a raised block towards the front. Put down two redstone wire and a torch here. Then a repeater on one tick there. If you want to mirror this, just make sure that you also place the block below the repeater, obviously. Then place a block in front of the repeater and a lowered block, then another raised block. In this gap, place a repeater on four ticks and a torch on top of this block. On top of that, an obsidian block and a torch going in the opposite direction than the repeaters. Next, grab your hoppers and place them next to the torch and the obsidian block facing each other, as you can see here. Then we need diagonal to those two blocks, so we can take outputs of both hoppers with comparators. In front of this comparator we need a raised block, here we need a lowered block with another comparator in this direction, which needs to be in the subtract mode. Run this directly into a full block with a torch to the front and the back. Then add a block below this hopper on the inside there. And then an L shape of three blocks here, so we can now connect this block we just placed with three redstone wire and the torch. Now you can just go and just simply place 23x or two stacks of x into this hopper here. The transfer should stop at 15x transferred. Then let's go and add a lowered block here with another comparator on top. Then we need a sticky piston, first another block and a second hopper. Comparator. And then we need the lowered sticky piston right there, followed by an upside down slab here. And on top of that, we need a sand block, which should be right in front of the comparator. Then around the corner, a block with some redstone dust on top. And at this point, I would recommend starting with some mirroring. So this next part here is not front to back symmetric, so here you just mirror right to left. We start right next to this cross of redstone dust with a raised block, and then a lowered block and another block here. Put first a comparator here, and then an upside down slab on top of this torch here with a comparator in the opposite direction. On the back side here, just place a normal block there, again with a comparator going outwards. Then we need a lowered obsidian block, basically, on top of this repeater down there. Put down two redstone wire. Grab a hopper, place it on top of the redstone wire on top of the obsidian block. Grab obsidian blocks and place five going diagonally up, starting right next to the hopper. Like so. Put down redstone dust on top of all these blocks, with the exception of the last obsidian block here. Then place three stacks of items inside of this. Half a stack of items inside of this hopper there. And then on the opposing side, we need a chest right behind the comparator, and here we need our three full stacks. Next, on the front, place a sticky piston on top of this block with an observer in front of it. Then with a one wide gap, we need a full block here. Then diagonally, powering downwards of that, we need a another observer with a repeater and two ticks on top. So basically, when this sticky piston extends, it will trigger as in final this observer over there. And that's this part. Then let's also add a block on top of this torch, torch on the outside, block on top, torch on the outside, block on top. And now let me quickly mirror this once more. Then let's quickly go and add one more block next to this redstone cross here. So we are somewhat symmetrical when it comes to those two blocks here. Now from this point on, we are back to our double symmetry. So once more, I show you 1/4 and then mirror it twice during the cuts. So let's start with this right at the center. For that, first grab a sticky piston and place it next to this normal block here, and then one below that and an observer on top of it. Now connect them with a column of 3 slime blocks. Add a column of 4 sticky pistons on top of the slime. Top that off with an obsidian observer. And now connect them with 5 slime blocks. Add a sticky piston on top. Then a normal piston to the front and the back of the observer here. And then with a 1 wide gap towards the inside, add sticky pistons like so. Then add another sticky piston down here. Place an observer facing upwards, spit out from the sticky piston essentially. Run this into a full block. Then go down twice. And then go with 2 blocks slightly lowered to the inside. Add redstone dust on top of those 2 blocks. And a repeater on 2 ticks on those 2 blocks each. Then on top of the comparator here, place a block and on the side of that block, a lever. Now, technically speaking, you only need this if you are in 1.15. In 1.16, you can leave that lever out. Then add another block here and put a comparator in a subtract mode on top of it. Make sure this is in a subtract mode. Then in front of that a block, then go up with another normal block and then diagonally with 3 obsidian blocks, put redstone dust on top of all these with the exception of the last obsidian block. Then, well, quickly mirror this. Following that, go to the middle here and down here, from the block in between the 2 repeaters, place an obsidian block going up diagonally and then in the reverse direction diagonally up a normal block. Put a redstone cross on top of the obsidian block. Grab a couple sticky pistons and place a column of 4 right on top of the normal block we just placed and top that off with an observer. Put down 5 slime blocks in front of that and top that with a sticky piston and a sticky piston to the outside like this here. Then grab an observer, place it on top of this 2-tick repeater there, put a full block on top, another full block on top of the observer there, and then 2 redstone wire like in this here. Now grab a sticky piston, place it next to this first obsidian block right in this stairs here. Put an observer powering upwards in front of it, then on top of that one we need 2 sticky pistons, topped with an observer, put 3 slime blocks as you can see here, and top that with another observer right here. Then let's go down here and first add another 3 blocks going up diagonally like so. Put down 3 redstone wire here. Then we need an upside down slab on top of this stairs block here. So let me quickly put it right here. Put another upside down slab next to this sticky piston there. And then following that 2 normal blocks, put down 3 redstone wire and a repeater on 4 ticks like this here. Then grab an observer, place it on top of the torch, run this into a full block with a node block next to that. On top of that we need another observer and an observer looking at it from the side, running into a full block with a lowered block to the side and then a redstone cross on top of that one. Now grab a sticky piston, place it next to or in front of this block here, then 1 sticky piston above and below that one. Grab a normal piston, place it in this corner, and one normal piston on top of that. Top them with an obsidian block, then at the back here we need a sticky piston, and then another obsidian block right in front of this observer there. Then place two normal pistons like so. Grab a sticky piston and place it in this up on top of this little corner here, so it can actually retract this observer here, which then would allow for this segment here to actually move forward. Then let's go and add another sticky piston on top of this very block here with an observer powering towards the back here. Run this directly into a full block with a upside down slab diagonally down like so. Place some redstone dust on top of this block, which should connect to this wire down here. Place another raised block here with some redstone dust there, then another block there, repeater on one tick. They're running into a full block like that. Then while we're here, let's actually grab our dropper, place it on top of this block here, running in the opposite direction to the repeater down there, and a hopper running into the dropper, as you can see here. Then you can already place a single item inside of this hopper-dropper combination. Now let's go and add a lowered block in this corner there, a repeater on two ticks taking output from this block there and running into a full block. Then a block here, a raised block there, a lowered block here. Now grab a comparator, place it here and another one there. Put down two redstone wire like so. An upside down slab next to this hopper there, put some redstone dust on top and a full block on top of the hopper. Then let's go and add two upside down steps here and some redstone dust on top. Now this is how you have to build it for 1.16 and later. If you are still in 1.15, simply replace this redstone wire with a full block and you're golden. But since I'm already in 1.17 when I'm recording this, we will need a block of redstone wire there. Anyway, now let's quickly mirror this a few more times. Then grab a node block and place it next to this raised block here with the redstone wire, and also on top of this normal piston there. I would also recommend placing a block on top of this node block, or it will make unnecessary noise. Another full block on top of this one here. Then an upside down step next to that, and an observer looking at this node block here and running into this redstone wire. Then a full block on top of this redstone wire, and in this gap here we need a repeater on two ticks running in the direction of this node block there. Now on the outside here, first place a full block on top of this observer, top that with a node block, then on top of that we need three observers, then an observer going outwards from the middle, running into a full block, then a lowered full block here with some redstone dust on top. Full block on top of this one here and this one here. Put some redstone dust there and a repeater on one tick there. Then grab sticky pistons, place two here. Then at the back we need two normal pistons, the same on the inside here. And now let's quickly mirror this once more. The next few blocks only need to be added to the front of the build and not the back, but to both sides. First go down where we have this torch tower going on, and here you go in the opposite direction with two blocks. Then, before you start adding anything else, place a block right here. Then start at the top here and go down with three redstone wire. I'm going in this order so you don't accidentally power anything with this powered redstone wire here connecting to what you don't want to actually power. Then on top of here we need an upside down slab. And then we go one layer up and place some redstone wire like so. Then around the corner we go up twice, put some redstone wire here and a torch there. And that's this side done. Now let's quickly mirror this, and then from there on we are back to a double symmetry again. Now back to our front right quarter. Let's get to our dropper here, place a block in front of it, then diagonal that Obsidian block down with a comparator up on top of it, which basically takes an output from the dropper there. This is run into two sticky pistons at the same height and one below. And in front of them we have observers which basically power towards the center line here. Next, grab a node block and place it right on top of our dropper there. Then let's go to the outside here. First place two blocks towards the front in this case from the node block there. Then we go diagonally down here until we are at this point here. And then one up. Put down two redstone wire in the middle like this. Then next to this block, place a sticky piston with a spit out observer to the face, like so. Then place two blocks like this here and then a raised block here. Put down two redstone wire, I repeat on one tick there. Some redstone wire on top of this one here in the cross shape. Then we need two normal pistons like this here and then three sticky pistons like this here. And now we can once more mirror. And voila, so now everything is properly mirrored. I also corrected what went wrong in this corner over there during one of the earlier cuts. But now let's continue on. First, I would actually recommend placing any kind of block on top of those four node blocks here, or you will get simply crazy with the noise they produce. Then let's continue on. Now for this front half, you have a rather nice focus point with this torch here, just place a block on top and then go to down diagonally and to up diagonally in the opposite direction. Then add another block here and then a node block here. And when you want to mirror this, just go from this node block on and then mirror it from there on. This is easier to find then. So anyway, let's see. First we need some redstone wire up to this point right on top of the torch. Then here we have a torch and then a torch on top of this block. Now we have three more blocks. First a repeater on three ticks, then four ticks running into a full block with a torch on top, then a block on the side of that one and a torch on the side of that one. Put an observer on top of the torch and the first repeater. Then we need our two hoppers facing each other, like so. Then put full blocks next to them, then a layer down. We need another two blocks with comparators, which once more take an output from those hoppers there. Then we need a sticky piston right here. Some redstone dust in a cross shape here and a full block there. Then another full block right here. Load block here with a comparator in a subtract mode there, which runs directly into a full block with a torch to the side of it. Sorry, with some redstone in a cross shape on top of it. Then to the side of that we need a full block. Then a redstone torch there. Following that, place an upside down snap here with some redstone dust on top. Then a repeat on one tick there, which finally runs into a full block right there. And now it's time to place two stacks of X inside of these hoppers here. The transfer should stop at 15X transferred. So as you can see, 15X have been transferred. Now before I continue, a quick correction. Those two blocks here, the redstone dot and the full block, need to be switched around, so the block is actually in the corner. This is required for the connection to the top later on. Next, let's go to this block here, where the subtracting comparator is running into. And below that we need a block hovering with some redstone dust on top. Then a torch on the inside. Now let's go down. First, I would recommend placing a temporary block here and then below that the sticky piston facing directly down, then you can remove this block again. Now you should have a one high gap right in here, and that's where you place an observer which powers this block here with the repeater taking output from. Then let's continue on and let's place a block next to the redstone cross and then a lowered block here with a comparator taking an output. Now first we need to go with two upside down slabs in this direction. Then somewhat in the similar direction we continue with two normal blocks. From this normal block on, go down thrice diagonally with obsidian blocks, which should be in line with those obsidian blocks down here. Then let's go and place some redstone wire on top of all these blocks here. On this side, go diagonally down with an upside down slab. Following that, place a normal block and then another two upside down slabs. Put some redstone dust here, here and here, cut off the wire there, and then we need a repeater here on two ticks. And it appears I'm getting a bit tired already. There is once more a little correction. This upside down slab here, right behind those normal pistons, actually needs to be a full block. So once we have corrected that, let's continue on. For that, first let's go to this corner here and there place a sticky piston facing downwards. Then while we're here, let's place an observer powering downwards right below this upside down slab and next to that. And now let's connect them to this sticky piston here with an L shape of three sticky pistons, slime blocks like this here. Then next, let's go and let's place a sticky piston right there. On top of the sticky piston, place a node block, and I would recommend placing a block on top of that one so it's not driving you crazy with the noise. Next, an observer running towards the front right in front of that. And below that observer, we need two sticky pistons, and below that, another observer. Then place down three slime blocks as you can see here. Then a sticky piston right there. And another sticky piston right here. Now grab another sticky piston, place it in this gap here. Then place an obsidian block in front of that very observer on top of that. Holding that, let's go and add a sticky piston in this corner next to this normal block and then another three sticky pistons below it. Below that, then a node block, observer. Connect them with five slime blocks. Then we need a sticky piston to the outside and below it. And now let's quickly mirror this a few more times. The next part is not front to back symmetric, so I will show you just how to build it on the right side and then mirror it towards the left. For that, let's start at the center, place an obsidian block at the back right next to this top piston there and put some redstone dust on top. Then let's go and let's add a sticky piston on the front of our build in this corner with an observer powering inwards. On the opposing side, go down here and first place two blocks. Take an output from this block here with a repeater on four ticks, which you run into some redstone wire, and on top of that an observer. Then here, place a comparator, taking an output from this block there, and running directly into a full block. Now diagonally to that, we need a hopper, and then next to that, an obsidian block, and then we go down four more times with obsidian blocks in a diagonal fashion, similarly or somewhat mirrored to what we did down here. Put redstone dust on top of those. then cut off the wire here with a full block. And I just noticed I forgot to top that node block there. Anyway, let's continue on. Now, if you are in 1.15, all you need to do is place a block here and put some redstone dust on top, so an obsidian block and then some redstone dust on top. If you are in 1.16 or later, instead you will need a hopper with some redstone dust on top, and then you will have to redirect this wire. And for that, you need to go two towards the back, then one up and place a block there, and then on the side of that, place a lever. Then next, grab some sticky pistons. We start with two sticky pistons here and here, with a observer right below. Put three slime blocks in front, and then we need four sticky pistons below that, like so. Following that, an observer, then slime blocks in front of them, as you can see here. Then in those two corners, normal pistons, then somewhat split out, sticky pistons, and then another sticky piston down here. So you can see the overall setup of pistons is also top to bottom symmetric. Grab a sticky piston and place it right at the bottom of this three-high strip of slime blocks. Then on top of that we need two normal pistons and the same up here. So now the entire thing should be once more pretty symmetrical. Now grab some slime blocks. First we start with a two-high column in front of this sticky piston there, then a two-high column here, now an L shape of three here, another two-high column here, and another two-high column here. Now it's time for the honey blocks. First we go to this piston in the corner there, then with a one wide gap we start with some honey blocks and we should end up with this three wide or three long L shape. The same we build on top of here, more or less a mirror image. Then place a simple row of four honey blocks in front of this sticky piston, then five in front of this one and six in front of this one. Another five up here, and then grab your slime blocks again at four here and six here. Grab a couple normal pistons, place one in this U-shape of blocks, then this inverted U-shape, and then inside of this little area here. And voila, so now we are almost done. We still can't test everything because parts of the segments here won't properly retract when there are no wall blocks in front of them. So let's start with placing blocks in front of all honey and slime blocks that are actually part of this moving wall segment, and also in front of the corresponding normal pistons here. Let me very quickly do this. And almost finished with that. Then we can already place obsidian blocks where the honey and the slime blocks will be moving next to. And the last one should be here. And now, once we have mirrored this a few more times, we can do the first test run. And voila, so now everything is ready for our first test of the sides. Took long enough, so let's see. And if we have built everything correctly, this should be the result. So as you can see, everything is closed up properly. And now let's open it up. And let's hope that everything retracts properly. And that's a go. Perfect. Now let's close the door again, because similar to the bottom, there are some segments behind the walls that are actually getting in contact with the walls. And the easiest way to figure out which ones are the affected ones is just closing the door and then just adding obsidian blocks wherever slime blocks or honey blocks make it involved. And here it may be a bit more tricky to get in there, but it's not impossible. And then let's go over here. And with that, it's time to once more open the door, and then you can simply fill in the rest of the wall with normal blocks. And voila, so now everything is finished up for the sides. I give them off camera another test run to see if I overlooked anything. It looked good so far, which means now it's time to start building the top part. Now before we can get to actually building the top part, there is a rather important test you have to make to ensure that you build the entire thing the correct way around. There is a 50% chance that you build it the wrong way without making this test, and if you build it the wrong way, you basically have to redo the entire top part. So make the test in the beginning, not like myself, and don't lose about an hour of work like I did in recording this tutorial. Anyway, the test is rather simple. You go to the front right corner, and in front of that, at the same height as this block, you place a sticky piston downwards and then another sticky piston below that. Then, at the height of the bottom piston, you place an upside down slab, and then behind that, a block with a torch. And then lastly, you power the pistons via a redstone wire. Now, as you can see here, the bottom piston actually got powered first. This has to do with update order, and that is a behavior that toggles every time you move this setup a block in any direction. Up, down, north, south, west, east, doesn't matter. If you move it by one block, this behavior toggles, which you can see over here. As you can see, this is an odd number of blocks of translation from over there to here, and subsequently the behavior has toggled in relation to over there. And you can see here the top piston was triggered first. And this is a behavior that can break the top part if you build it the wrong way around. So for this tutorial, I'm going with a situation where I have the bottom piston activated on the right side. If you have made this test and the top piston is activated on the right half, you have two options. Either you rotate what I'm showing you in the following by 180 degrees, so basically switch front, back and left, right around, or you mirror it left to right. Doesn't really matter which way you go, the result is the same. But this test is very important, and in 50% of the cases, as you have seen here, you will guess wrong. So make this test and avoid a lot of headaches. So now that we have figured out the correct orientation of the top part, let's, for my situation, go to the front left corner. And here we start by adding three blocks going diagonally up like this. Then put down three redstone wire and a sticky piston on top of the last block. Block to the face of it, then to the front and to down another block with a torch on top, which will power the block once the piston extends. Then towards the back, add eight blocks in a row, five redstone wire, followed by a repeater on three and two repeaters on four ticks each. Run them into a full block with some redstone dust on top, block to the side and a torch to the side of that one. Then two hoppers facing each other, like so. Then diagonally down, we need two blocks with two comparators on top, taking outputs from the hoppers. Get your observers, place one on the last wire and the first repeater. Then a block up there and redstone dust here. Sticky piston next to this block and then a block below that one and in front of this comparator. Block here, put a comparator on the subtract mode on top. Then another block here, comparator there. Run this directly into a full block. Then towards the front and the back we need two blocks. Put redstone dust on top of those. Then on the back here, add a torch on the side of this block. Then a block below this hopper there and a lowered block here with some redstone dust on top. Then a sticky piston facing forward or towards the middle with an observer running into this direction here. Then diagonal to that, a sticky piston facing downwards with an observer powering in the same direction as this one up there. Block here and a 2-tick repeater right there. Then let's quickly go up here and now let's place some items inside of those eggs. First, in the hopper on the inside, we need to add 12 eggs and then in the other one 19 eggs. So 4 and 15 will be later on what you will see. Then let's go down here and from here on the next few parts can be once more mirrored from front to back. So let's start by placing a block along the center line here, then three blocks towards the back, add redstone dust on top. Block around the corner with a repeater on 4 ticks running directly into a obsidian block with some redstone dust on top. Then place two raised blocks here, redstone dust on top of this one and a repeater on 2 ticks there, running directly into a full block, followed by an obsidian block, then two blocks around the corner, another one, then three raised blocks and two lowered blocks. Redstone dust on top of those blocks, like this here. Then let's go and grab a hopper, place it on top of the repeater. Repeater on top in the opposite direction on 2 ticks. Then blocks to the front and the back of that one, and on top. Put down 2 redstone wire like this here. Then 2 more blocks up there with redstone dust on top. Let's add a sticky piston right next to this first normal block there and another 2 to the side, followed by an observer. Then 4 slime blocks below and sticky pistons to the front, back and the side of this end right there. Then another sticky piston in this corner here with an observer running into this direction. Diagonal that we need a full block with another 3 blocks in a row there. Then we go up by a layer, add a node block on top of this. I would recommend placing a block on top to make this silent and then just place some redstone wire all the way over there. Following that, let's go back to this center part here. First add another block to this side. On top of that we need a comparator and a subtract mode. Now the next 3 blocks don't need to be mirrored, only the next 3 blocks. The first is this obsidian block, the second is the comparator on top, and the last is the chest right behind this comparator. In the chest, place exactly 3 stacks of items. Then continue on this line here with an obsidian block, and then we go down 3 times diagonally with obsidian blocks. Put redstone dust on top of those 4 obsidian blocks. Then let's go to this side again, place a block on top of this comparator, then a block towards the front. Redstone wire here and a repeater on 1 tick there, running directly into a full block with a lowered block to the side. Another block here, then grab some slabs, place 4 in a row here, so basically hovering above those 4 pistons. Then next to the middle 2 normal blocks and then another slab upside down. Put a row of wire along this edge, then we need some repeaters, 1 on 2 ticks here, 4 ticks here and 1 on 4 ticks there, and some redstone wire there. Grab an observer, place it looking at this repeater and another one looking at this wire. Place full blocks to the faces of them and then go below here and place a double piston extender here. And that is the place where this toggling behavior actually can break the circuitry. And if it's just the wrong way, then this part here will never completely extend, and basically the middle segments will get stuck at basically no extension. Next, add another three sticky pistons to this row down here. Following that, an observer. Now place a row of 5 slime blocks, a sticky piston on the end here, another sticky piston diagonal to the last sticky piston up there, and then an observer powering that from the side. And now let's actually place a node block on top of this one here. I would recommend placing something on top to make this silent, and then in the middle a block down here with some redstone dust. And next, place a block in front of this redstone wire there. Torch around the corner. Then down here, next to the node block, an upside down step, followed by two normal blocks going outwards. On the blocks, place two 4-tick repeaters. Then place the redstone wire here. Next, a sticky piston facing downwards next to the blocks. Below that, an observer, and then hovering below that, an obsidian block with some redstone dust on top. The next few parts don't need to be mirrored, we only need to place them once, and for that, let's go to this torch here. First, we go up diagonally 4 times, like so. Then we continue on this line until we reach this place with the diagonal wire, where we don't want to cut it off, so we need an upside down step there. Add 2 more blocks to this row, then 2 around the corner, 1 raised block, 1 lowered block. Then in this corner here we need a repeater, and then a line of wire all the way over there, but while we're here, let's actually cut off the wire here, since we don't want any connection there. And now let's continue on with the wire. And at this point we can actually test this left side and see if we have built it correctly. So click the or press the button, and you should see those parts here piece by piece coming down, and if it can extend to this point, then it has been built on the correct side. If it gets stuck due to this double extender not extending at all, or basically just extending once, then you have built it on the incorrect side and will have to basically destroy everything up there and build it on the other side. Now let's see if the retraction also works. And that's basically what we want to see. So this side is now more or less done, except for the actual movements and some pistons, but for now let's go to the right side. So now for the right side, we start at the front corner, or at least in my configuration here, we start in the front corner. Again, with going up 3 times with blocks. This time we need 4 redstone wire. Then a sticky piston right in front of the wire. Again, block to the face, then 1 front and 2 down, another block with a torch on top. Then towards the back, at a row of 8 normal blocks, 5 redstone wire, 3 tick repeater, 4 tick repeater, 4 tick repeater, running into a full block with some redstone dust on top. Then inwards, at a block next to the dust and a torch on the side of that one. Place 2 hoppers facing each other as seen here. Then diagonally to those, we need 2 blocks down with comparators taking outputs from the hoppers. Grab 2 observers on top of the wire and the repeater there. Wire there, block there, and a sticky piston facing downwards with a full block to the face, which will connect to this comparator there. Then a block here with a comparator in the subtract mode, another block here with a comparator in the subtract mode. This time not running into any blocks, but a block down here. Then towards the back, we need a block at the same height and a raised block towards the front. Redstone dust on top of those. Then a torch on the side of this block. Block below this hopper on the outside. Lowered block here, followed by an upside down step and 2 redstone wire, which should connect to this one here. Now we can actually fill in our, 31x, and the transfer should stop at 12x transferred. You could alternatively first place 12x in here and then the rest in there. Now we need a sticky piston below this full block with an observer running in this direction here, directly running into a sticky piston with another observer in the opposite direction. Diagonal to that, we need a block down here so we can take an output with a repeater on 2 ticks. So the next few steps can be once more mirrored from front to back. So for that, let's start with a block right in front of this repeater there. Then another 6 lowered blocks along the central line. Put a repeater on 4 ticks on top of this block, following that 5 redstone wire. Then an obsidian block around the edge there, with some redstone dust on top. Then next to this first redstone wire block with redstone dust. Then we go down a layer, add 2 more blocks here, and then around the corner, a raised obsidian block. Again, redstone dust on top of those. A hopper on top of this corner, with a repeater going outwards on 2 ticks, then behind and in front, and on top of the repeater, obsidian blocks. Let's go back to this raised block again. Add a lowered block around the corner with a repeater on 2 ticks, running into a full block. Add another full block, obsidian block, 2 full blocks. Then around the corner another one. Then we go up a layer with 3 blocks. Down a layer with 1, then up with 1. In this corner place a node block. Then we need redstone wire on top of all these blocks, with the exception of this block at the very end. Then let's go back to the central line here, add a block there with some redstone dust on top, then a sticky piston, following that an observer, then 2 to the front and 1 down, a block with a repeater on 1 tick, which runs into a normal block with an observer around the corner, and then a raised block of obsidian. In this gap, place a repeater on 1 tick. After mirroring, let's go back to the central line here. First, place a block on top of this wire. Then, on top of this cross wire, we need an upside down slab. Place some redstone dust here, it should connect on one side. And a comparator on top of this block. That one runs into a full block with a load block around the corner. And then we go diagonally down with 3 obsidian blocks, which should end up nicely in this little corner there. Put down 4 redstone wire like this. Then it's time for some more pistons. Place a row of 4 sticky pistons beginning next to this normal block there. Then below them 4 slime blocks. Then a column of 2 slime blocks going in downwards. Grab your sticky pistons, place one here, another one there, and the last one, last observer running from the outside into this slime block there. Then let's go and continue on from this block here at this height. On the other side you need to go up a layer and then down a layer. Put down redstone wire all the way to down there. Grab your sticky pistons again, place 3 starting next to this normal block in a row, following that an observer. Put a row of 4 slime blocks there, and then sticky pistons to the front, the back, and the side of this end with the observer. Place a sticky piston in this corner with an observer running in this direction. Then diagonal to that we need a full block. Now place a node block on top of the observer and then some redstone dust right there. After mirroring, grab a couple more blocks and go to this corner here with the sticky piston up there. And diagonal to that we need a block here. Then go up diagonally towards the front here with 2 blocks. Place down 2 redstone wire. Then down in this corner we need a sticky piston with a observer powering towards the central line. Put a block diagonally like so, then put another 4 blocks in an L shape like this here. Finally, place a node block down here in this corner, or to be more precise, first place a same block here, and then on top of that the node block. It's a bit easier to place them that way. Then redstone wire on top of those five blocks here. Then a lowered block around this corner here, raised block, and then three lowered full blocks, which should cut off the connection here. Followed by a lowered block, put down four redstone wire and cut off the connection at this point with a full block, and in here we need a repeater on one tick. Then grab an observer, place it looking at this node block here. Another node block we need here. I would recommend placing a block on top of that one to make it silent. Then a sticky piston right below that, following that a slime block and another sticky piston. And behind that sticky piston we need an obsidian block. Then while we're here, let's place a few more obsidian blocks. So the first is right diagonally down behind this three wide strip of blocks. Same on this side. Then on this side here, so here we already have a obsidian block diagonally to the corner between those two sticky pistons. Here we need to do the same and also at the back, but only on this side. On this side we don't need to do that. That should be all of the missing obsidian blocks if I am correct. And well, let's now quickly mirror this. Now before we continue, one quick correction, and that has to do with the circuitry in here. I basically found a little bug issue that is hidden in the circuitry here, and the solution for that is rather straightforward. First, move this block of redstone wire up on top of a full block, then replace this block here with an upside down slab, and then make sure that you have a full block on top of the node block there. And with that, this issue should be resolved. Now with that done, it's time to give the entire thing a little test run. So when I trigger this, you should see first the center segments and then piece by piece the outer segments starting to come down until they are basically one flat area. And if you flick the lever again, or press the button once more, you can see that the whole thing looks in reverse. So the last to stop should be the center. Okay, that's looking good so far. Now it's time to fill in the segments in the center, and I will once more only show you the front half and mirror during the cuts. Anyway, we start at the pistons at the very center, and without any gap, just go down until we are just one above the future ceiling. And in this case, the middle is here, so we need to go right. This is the next one. It's part of this, or connected to the next inner one, so we need a one high gap. Again, down until we are here, and L shape in this direction. Then here we have, this is the first of the segment part, so down and again right. This is the second, so we need a one high gap, down and this time left. So you can see we get a pattern pretty similar to what we have at the bottom. Now let's continue on. So this is just our three high column. Then we have a one high gap and our L shape in this direction. And this is a two high gap, so we have just a straight row there. This is a short L. And this is again our column. Then a short L and a straight line. Then time for some sticky pistons, one here, two there, two here, one there. Normal pistons here, here, and here. And now we need to fill in normal pistons. Basically everywhere where we have slime blocks, we need in the row before them normal pistons one block higher. So here, there, there. Once more, pretty simple actually. And the last two there. And now we can give it another test run, just to be sure that we haven't accidentally destroyed anything. Because now we can still see somewhat what is going on. Later on that will become a bit harder. So that's looking good. So we have our pyramidal like shape. And now the retraction should also work. So let me quickly mirror this. And then it's time to start filling in a few blocks. Again, where we have pistons or slime blocks, we need the blocks in the ceiling. So let me quickly do this for this one half here. So, and here, and here, and the last few. And then obviously we also need to make sure that wherever slime blocks get involved, we have some obsidian blocks or other immovable blocks to make sure that nothing will get stuck. Okay, this is looking good. Now, similar to before, close the door, get to the inside, and then look where slime blocks will get in contact with the ceiling and add more obsidian blocks in those areas. So it's only on that one side over there, it seems. Okay, so then find your way out. You may have to open up your area somewhere, and then you have essentially a pattern for the second side. And you can also at the same time test if this side here is properly flattening out, and it appears to do so. So let's quickly finish in this ceiling here. And after running this entire thing, I also found four more spots where blocks would get stuck to moving slime constructs. So let me quickly add this in. And now we should actually have something that is very similar to what we have at the bottom, just in this case mirrored. Which means that the last parts are actually filling in the front and the back walls, a bit of the floor, maybe relocate the levers, and potentially light up the entire thing to keep mobs from spawning. A little side note here, I had to get a bit tricky when I wanted to relocate the lever to this very position here, since I had already some wire down here running. So I went with a setup like this here, since I only need at most 2 tick pulls, or at least 2 tick pulls for this thing here to toggle. So I could go with a rather simple setup down there. Anyway, that's pretty much the end of this tutorial about this pretty compact 14x14 double vault door. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, or well, not so little tutorial, and well, see ya!